thanks so much for stopping by. Today's video is going to be all about the brows. I'm going to be showing you how I fill in my brows, what products and tools that I use, and what steps I take to fill in my everyday go-to brow. So if you'd like to see how I fill in my brows, then please keep watching and I will take you through the steps. Alright, so as you can clearly tell, I went ahead and already filled in one brow, and it really does make a huge difference to your overall makeup look. Just by taking a few extra minutes or a few extra steps in your daily routine, you can make a huge difference in your makeup look. So there's really a ton of different ways that you can fill in your brows, whether you'd like to use a pencil or a powder or a combination of the two, maybe even just a brow gel. Really, it's up to you how you want to fill in your brows. So I like to start off by quickly grooming or combing through my brows. So I'm going to be using this Sonia Kashuk spoolie brush. This is from Target, and I think it was only a couple of dollars, and it really is a great tool, and I use it every day. So I recommend going to Target and checking it out if you need a spoolie. And I like to brush my front hairs going in the same direction, which is towards the arch of my brow. And then once I get there, I like to comb those hairs downwards. Now I'm going to go into my Anastasia Beverly Hills Beauty Express for Brows and Eyes palette. So what I like to do is take my e.l.f. small angled brush, or a small angled brush. Again, e.l.f., this is really inexpensive and it's also a really great quality tool. And I'm going to go into my Anastasia palette and I'm going to pick up some of the wax onto the e.l.f. small angled brush. So once I have some wax on the brush, I'm going to go ahead and brush over my hairs the same direction that I brushed with the spoolie. So these front hairs here, I want them to go all in the same direction towards my arch. And then once I get to that arch area, I like to brush the hairs down. Now, sometimes you have to be careful with the amount of wax that you put on. I have put on way too much wax before one time, and it just made all the powder clump in that area. So you really want to make sure to take the time just to comb that through and brush. Make sure you don't have any clumps of wax on your brow hairs, because we all know that's not a good look. So you can even go through one more time if you want with that spoolie and just brush through. Make sure that wax is evenly distributed. So to fill in my brows, I'm actually going to start off with a pencil. And the pencil I'm going to be using that I really like is this Ulta Ultimate Brows Shade and Shaper Pencil in Brunette. So this has the shaper or waxy side, as well as, of course, the pencil in your hair tone, as well as a little comb. So this little guy right here is actually a really great investment, especially if you want to just fill in your brow with a pencil. I filled in my brows with only this product and it's really great. It's not too expensive. Again, it's from Ulta, so, and it's lasted me a really long time. And today though, I'm just going to use it to help define underneath the brow. This line here makes it look really, really crisp, I like to say, or really fine and defined. So I'm going to do precisely that. I'm going to carefully draw a line right underneath the brow to define this line, and I'm actually going to elongate my brow a little bit out in the outer corner here. So I'm going to start in the inner portion of the brow and lightly define this lower portion of the brow. So I'm going to go up towards the arch, and I'm following the natural shape of my brow. So once you get to this arch area here, you're going to want to go down, obviously continuing following the shape of your brow. And I need to actually extend my brow a little bit in this outer area here. So what I like to do is take my pencil or a brush, even if you're only using a brush to apply your pencil, or even if you want to use a powder instead. I'm going to place whatever tool, the pencil here, right along here. It's almost the same exact concept of when you're doing your eyeliner, how you want the line to continue from your lower lash line and up. It's basically the same idea. So instead of connecting that all the way here, we're going to just extend this area right over here. So I don't need too much, but it really does make a big difference. A little goes a long way. So I'm going to go ahead and connect my natural brow and extend it a little bit out with the pencil. just like that. And you can always go back and double check by laying your pencil down. Use your pencil or your tool as a guide. They're great. That's what they're for. Multitask with your products. So once I have established that initial line, now I'm going to go in and use my powder. So I'm going to go back into my Anastasia Beverly Hills Beauty Express for brows and eyes and take the pencil that comes with it, which is the number 15. This sucker is great for applying your powder. And I'm going to be using first the light brown powder in the palette. And I'm just going to follow that line that I used with my Ulta pencil, but press the hairs upward. So again, I want to follow the direction that I want my hairs to go in, which is towards the arch. And then once I get to the arch, I'm going to be making the hairs go in that direction. Now for my arch area, I actually need to extend it a little bit, so I'm just going to fill in a little bit more here and then fill it in like that. To make your brow look a little bit more natural, you're actually going to take a little bit of the darker brown powder and I'm going to place that in the high points of the brow, so right here at the arch. And then any areas that look especially sparse, I don't know if you can tell, but right in here looks a little bit too sparse. I'm just going to actually press the darker powder into those areas. Then from there, I'm going to go back in with my spoolie brush and make sure to distribute that powder evenly. So this is my other brow done. I'm starting to feel a lot more balanced and put together, and it really did make a huge difference to my overall look just by taking this couple extra minutes to fill in my brow. I really hope that you found this video useful. If you need to know the name of any of the products that I showed in this video, I will have a link to my blog in the description box down below, and of course I will have a full list of the product names provided for you. Thank you once again so much for watching. I really hope that you enjoyed this video, and until next time, I hope that you have a beautiful day. Bye!